This video is sponsored by Audible. Audible lets you enjoy all your audio entertainment in one app. Whether you know what you love or you're looking for something new, Audible offers an incredible selection across every genre. Audiobooks of all styles, podcasts, and Audible originals. And as an Audible member, you can choose one title a month to keep, including the latest bestsellers and new releases. You'll also get access to the growing selection of included audiobooks, originals, and podcasts, and download and stream those all you want. The Audible app makes it very easy to listen anytime, anywhere. I personally listen a lot in the car, and in the shower, and when I'm getting ready to film. It also will hold your spot across different devices, which I find very nifty. I am ecstatic to recommend a podcast to you this month. It's called Trojan War, the podcast. It is a serialized telling of the stories that together comprise the epic story of the Trojan War. It's by storyteller Jeff Wright. It's 20 episodes long, each one well over an hour, and when I say it gripped me, I loved it so much. It's a very unintimidating way to get into the Trojan War story and the Iliad as well. Jeff does a really fantastic job keeping you engaged and also includes chats at the end of each episode talking about different topics that have to do with the history and context of the story itself. It was really good. I'm actually planning a Trojan War roleplay soon, and definitely am using this as one of my sources to write from. I'm very excited, and I was actually so eager for my next Audible read, just so I could recommend this to you. So, if you would like to listen to Trojan War the podcast, or thousands of other titles, go to audible.com/GB, or text GB to 500-500. That's audible.com/GB. Or text GB to 500-500. Thank you, Audible, for sponsoring today's video, and thank you for watching. Hello, everybody. It's GB. I'm so excited for this video. I am in cozy mode because for some reason, this day just zoomed by, and it's like super late now, but somehow more mechanical keyboards. So obviously, lips themselves are quite smooth. They're very puffy, like little clouds. Or like cartoon teeth. Hopefully it doesn't ruin that for you. Alright. So, I'm going to do the same thing that I did with my speed typing video. And we're going to put the monkey type here. So you can see what I'm typing. This is not a speed video, though. Maybe with the last keyboard we'll do like one speed run, but if you want to see me type fast, I'll link that video. This is just for audio purposes. My nails are Holo Doco, their new Holo Light collection. Thank you for sending. And my rings, these two are from, they're from Be So Lovely, which is an incredible small business that you should definitely check out. Also, my wedding ring and my engagement ring.
Yes.
this is my first failure. Not in life. Many failures in life. My first failure. My first attempt and my first failure. So, as you guys know, I'm a newbie of, like, the mechanical keyboard scene, and let me tell you, the mechanical keyboard community is bumping. If you are actually, like, involved in mechanical keyboards and you know what you're talking about, my keyboard videos are probably not that satisfying to you, because you're like, girl, you have no idea what you're talking about. Facts. But how is anyone supposed to learn without experimenting? So, I was like, I love mechanical keyboards. I would like to know more about them. So, we got that switch tester. We did that. And I had seen some keycaps that I really liked. They are from the brand Escape Keyboard, I believe. They are called the Palm Jelly Keycaps. I bought them myself. Saw them. Wanted them. Got them. And so I was like, okay, what can I put these on? I need like a bass and like switches and all that jazz, and then you put the keys onto the keyboard. Alright, baby steps, I'm gonna learn how to do this. So I bought this Wumie. It's spelled M-W. God, it's spelled W-O-M-I-E-R. I feel like it's gonna be called Wumie, but maybe it's Wumier, I don't know. I bought the K61 acrylic mechanical keyboard, and I was like, this will be perfect to put on it. This whole, like, part lights up. It's going to light up the jelly keycap so nice. It looks so satisfying and so plush and squishy. And I cannot tell you the absolute nightmare it was for me to put it together. I broke like 3 nails because I did not know what I was doing. I finally figured out a better way to get the caps on and off. I had no idea that there were numbers underneath each keycap that would tell me exactly where it needed to go. So I was like, got a magnifying glass out, because obviously these are not labeled. Basically, I made it really hard on myself, and this was during, I was self-quarantining from Ben because he got COVID, and I was like, this will be a good project to keep my mind off of things wrong. It was the worst. So basically, long story short, I finally get it together, and I'm like, thank God I did it. It was tough, it was rough, but I kept it together, and I go to plug it in, and I'm like, I'm gonna see it glow. I'm gonna see it shine. It's gonna be amazing. And it short-circuited. I don't know whether it was what I plugged it into. I don't know whether it was the outlet. I don't know. I don't know if this was just a defective keyboard. But it short-circuited, and it never lit up. And now this is broken. So this is a non-functional keyboard. I need to just buy another one and do it again, but I'm stalling. But anyway, it's not gonna light up, so it's not as fun. Way less fun, actually. But I am going to type on it. I got Gateron black switches, and they sound amazing, so just do a little bit of typing for you. Themselves, I find very satisfying. The texture It's not super overwhelmingly backlit, I would say, but it's cool that like these are showing up red and these are showing up like green and blue. I do not know what switches are on here, but this is the second keyboard that Osseo sent me. I think this is a brand new one. They did a Kickstarter or something. This is the Cascade. It is also wireless. I do have it plugged in, but it's a wireless backlit mechanical keyboard, hot swappable switches, 75% layout, and this sound damper layer. I'm wondering if that's what's doing it for me. 9 LED colors, 4 RGB light modes, aluminum top case. Here we go. First things first. This keyboard deserves the dragon. I'm gonna put it on the escape key. Sorry, I had to cut that out a little bit because... Okay, first of all, I don't know how to take keycaps off. I think I just killed some of you inside. This looks like some sort of... It's a brown switch. I'm not sure what brand, but it is certainly brown. Just put it in. nowhere.